Hello everyone, I'm Charles. Welcome to Graphic Design Quick Start. In today's episode, I'll be showing you how to design a stained glass window in Photoshop. This is the effect we are meant to achieve, together with the cracked window. We'll start from this stained glass ornament that we created in our previous video. We'll be creating the stained glass window effect on an alpha channel. Let us create one. Go to the channel panel. Hold Alt, Option Mark, and click on the plus icon to create a new alpha channel. Let us call it Paints. Let's go to the color channel. Press D for default foreground and background colors. Change the percentage to 50%. This is because we need to generate some clouds and we need them to be faint. Go to Filter, Render, Clouds, and there we have our faint clouds. Press D again for default foreground and background colors. Go to Filter, Filter Gallery. If you are using another version of Photoshop, you would go to Texture, then Stained Glass. Let's click on Filter Gallery. Go to Texture, click on Stained Glass. The stained glass effect always creates the borders using the foreground. In our case, the foreground is white. Change the cell size to 40. The border thickness to 10. Light intensity 0. Click OK. Let's go back to our channel panel. Now we need to separate the panes and the borders. Duplicate the panes channel by dragging it to the plus icon. Let us call it bevel. This will be the beveled lines. Press Ctrl L, Command L on the mark to bring the levels adjustment. Drag the black point to the right of the histogram to learn 115. That is immediately after the last histogram spike. Click OK. Now let us convert the alpha channels into layers. Hold on Ctrl, Command and mark, and click on the paint channel. That loads it as a selection. Switch to the RGB. Switch to the layer channel. Click on the hue saturation layer. Press Ctrl Shift N. Command Shift N on a mark to create a new layer. Let us call it Paints. Fill it with white. That is Ctrl Backspace. Command Backspace on a mark. Since our background color is white, go back to the channel panel. Hold Ctrl, Command on Mac, and click on a bevel channel. Go back to the layers panel. Click on the existing bevel layer. Press Ctrl Shift N, Command Shift N on Mac to create a new layer. Let us call it Bevel 2. Click OK. Go to the color channel. Assuming you're looking at the HSB values, change here to 0, saturation to 0. A brightness to 25. Just in case you don't have the HSB values, go to the channel's flyout menu and click on HSB sliders. Let's go back to the layers panel. Press Alt Backspace, Option Delete on a mark to fill the layer with a dark gray. Now we need to reposition the layers so that we can avoid the borders at the edge. Also, to make sure a bad ornament is not cut off on weird places. While the bevel 2 layer is still selected, hold Ctrl, Command on Mac, and click on the paints layer. Holding Ctrl or Command down help us select non-adjacent layers. Make sure you don't click on the thumbnail. You click somewhere empty on the side. Clicking on the thumbnail will load it as a selection. Let us scale the layers. Go to Edit, Fleet Transform, or press Ctrl T, Command T on a Mac. Go to the options bar. Make sure the chain icon is active. Change the width and the height to 120%, or whichever scale that works for you. Let us reposition it. The next step is to mask the layers. Go to the hummingbird layer, hold on Alt, Option and Mac, and drag the layer mask to the paints layer. That gives us the opposite of what we need. Click on the layer mask thumbnail, press Ctrl I, Command I on mark to invert it, hold on Alt, Option on mark, and drag the layer mask to the bevel tool layer. Now let us merge the two bevel layers. Click on the bevel layer with the mask. Go to layers, merge down, hold Ctrl E, Command E on a Mac. That will merge the top layer with the layer image tree below it. The two layers are now merged and also adopt the bevel effect. Let us add some more effects. Go to the bottom of layers panel, click on the FX icon, click on drop shadow so that you can cast shadows on our lines. Change the opacity to 50. Distance to 5, the size to 5, click on Auto Grow, click on the color swatch, change the color to white, change the opacity to 50, the spread to 0, the size to 65, and the range to 50, click OK. Let us temporarily hide the bevel layer. You can see we have these white lines that are encroaching to the bar layer. We also have a chance to appear around the perimeter of the bevel lines. Let us get rid of them. Click on the pen layer thumbnail. Make sure they're not linked. Go to Filter, Other, Maximum. Give it a radius of 4. What Maximum does, it expands the transparent area. Click OK. Now you have some nice thin lines, but they're a little bit rough. Let us move them with the blur. Go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Give it a value of 8. That is double the value of the maximum. Click OK. We zoom out, our paints are still visible. Let us reinstate our bevel layer. Next, let us go to a background layer. Click on it. Let us blur it a little. Let us apply the blur as a smart filter. First, convert the layer to a smart object. Mine is already converted, but just in case yours is not, go to the Layers panel, Flyout menu, and click on Convert Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and give it a blur of 10. Let us scroll down, double click on the double sided icon on the right of Gaussian Blur. Let us change the opacity to 60% so that we can show through more of the details of the background. Click OK. Our final step is to introduce the clocked pen. Click on the eyeball to show it. You can place it whatever you want. Let us place it here. Pick the polygonal lasso tool. Click along the edges. Go to the bottom of the layers panel, click the add mask icon, change the layer blend mode to multiply. Let us hide the layers panel. Press Ctrl 0 to feed the layers to the window, Command 0 on a Mac. And that's how you design a stained glass window in Photoshop. That's it for today. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss out on our next episode.